I'm Steve Valiquette for Hockey Night Live, and like we've established on the show this season, I have no life. I've watched every single goal that's been scored in the National Hockey League this season, and I've learned a few things, and I'd like to share them with you today. Of all the goals scored this year in the National Hockey League, 76% have been off high percentage shots, shots that I call green shots. And only 24% of all goals being scored this year have been off low percentage shots, shots that I call red shots. These high percentage green shots occur when the goaltender has less than half of a second to see the shot. There are seven criteria that I'm going to break down now. Possession across the Royal Road, passes across the Royal Road, deflections, one-timers on the same side of the Royal Road, screens, broken plays, and green rebounds. The Royal Road is a line that goes directly down the ice from the middle of one net to the other, and it separates the ice into two equal parts. There's also a second line that comes across the top of the circle, and any play that crosses the Royal Road increases the shooter's scoring opportunity by seven times. Now, Vladimir Tarasenko, if he just shoots on this one-on-three, he only has a 4% chance of scoring. But he knows better, and his instincts tell him to cross the Royal Road, and he does that on this play and exposes Corey Schneider. The pass across the Royal Road, well, this is the second most valuable scoring opportunity in hockey. And this is any pass that goes across that line below the tops of the circles that results with a shot on goal. These types of sequences are very necessary during the power play. And you can see what happens to Chad Johnson of the New York Islanders on this clip. He has no chance to get into a set position and to make his save. Another example of a green shot is a deflection. Deflections are extremely challenging because as the puck is traveling towards the goalie and it changes directions, it makes it very difficult for the goalie to pick it up and control. Look at the set play here from the New York Islanders, and rather than shooting this long, low percentage red shot, Johnny Boychuk makes a beautiful heads-up slap pass to Josh Bailey in the high slot, giving Ben Bishop very little time to pick up the release and make a save. Another green shot is a quick passing play that occurs on either side of the Royal Road. This shooting sequence is tough for a goalie because he has less than half of a second of clear sight and setup time before the puck releases from the shooter's stick. But it's not quite as valuable as a Royal Road pass because the goalie has to move less and move less distance into position to make a save. On this bang-bang play, Chris Kreider sends a fantastic dish to Matt Zuccarello, and it's in the back of the net before Reimer knows what happens. Goaltending in today's NHL is so strong that teams have no choice but to layer bodies in front of the goalie in an attempt to score. As we can see here, Jake Allen has his own teammate, Jay Bouwmeester, flamingoing in front of him in the high slot, plus a double screen in front and tight to the net. He has no chance to see the puck off the release and no chance to make this save. Broken plays are dreadful for NHL goalies and they happen often. All of Henrik's body weight is shifted towards the back door, attempting to make a save on Brock Nelson, but that puck doesn't get there. Kevin Klein breaks it off as that pass is being made, and it ends up in the back of his net. So as we wrap up all the green opportunities that we've covered so far, a green rebound is any scoring opportunity that comes off the goaltender that originated from a green shot. There's one here on Jimmy Howard through a screen, which is a green play on net, that ends up a rebound goal. Now that we know how green shots work, let's take a look at how the percentages have broken down amongst these seven categories. And for me, when I see 22% of the goals being scored this season on passes across the Royal Road, and I add that to the 8% of possession across the Royal Road, that's 30% of all offense this year off of green shots on two categories, and 76% of total offense in the National Hockey League. And now we're gonna look at the other end of the spectrum, red shots. These are the low percentage shots on net where the goalie has more than half of a second of sight to see the shot. 18% of all the goals scored this season have been off red shots, and 7% off red rebounds. Now the thing that gets me here is, on any given night, teams in the National Hockey League right now are taking three times as many red shots as they are green shots. This is a prime example of a red shot. The shooter never crosses the Royal Road. The goalie has clear sight lines, giving the shooter only a 4% chance of scoring. This one here is a red net play. The goalie has more than half of a second of sight to see the shot. This shouldn't end up in the net, but it does on this play. Again, in today's NHL, goaltenders are held to a high standard, and on wraparounds and net plays, the goaltender has to control the puck and cannot allow it out into the middle of the ice. If you see an NHL goalie giving up a couple of these in a hockey game, you're going to see a goalie getting pulled. Now here's another example of a red rebound. This is a play that develops off the rush where the goalie should not just be stopping this puck, but is required to control it. And this puck shouldn't end up in the back of the net. It is now considered a bad goal. And remember, 76% of all goals in the NHL are scored on green shots, with only 24 being red. Do you really want your team shooting low percentage red shots? Now, I know that's a lot to digest, and it was a lot for me to work through. But don't worry about it. There's going to be a lot of coverage this season on MSG.com, as well as Saturday nights on Hockey Night Live.